Whether you own a 30-foot cruiser or a 12-foot John boat like this one here, there's some safety precautions you need to take before you put the boat out on the water the first time during the early boating season. One of the most neglected pieces of equipment on a boat is the boat trailer. And this is where the problem's gonna start, right here, is the tires. They either go flat, they blow out, or the bearing seize on the axle. And there's some safety precautions you can use to make this not happen. Always check your tire pressure while the tires are cold. The tire will actually have the appropriate tire pressure on the sidewall of the tire. So check your tire pressure before you ever start. Make sure that the lug nuts are tight. It's always a good idea to carry a four-way lug wrench with you and make sure that the lug nuts are tight before you start. Wheel bearings are another problem. As you notice on this particular trailer, it has a set of buddy bearings on it. What that does, buddy bearings does, is it keeps a constant pressure of grease on the bearings. With a buddy bearing, you can use a grease gun. Just attach the grease gun to the grease fitting and put grease in the buddy bearing. If you don't have a buddy bearing, then the only way you can get grease to the bearings is to hand pack the bearings. That's something that should be done twice a year at your marine dealership. Always use a hand grease gun and not a grease gun that uses compressed air, because that has a tendency to put too much pressure or too much grease into the buddy bearing and can blow the back seal out. Let's talk about attaching the trailer to the tow vehicle. The coupler on all trailers should have the size of the coupler itself. This is a 2-inch coupler. Therefore, the tow vehicle should have a 2-inch ball. It also should be stamped on the ball. What you don't want to do is have too small a ball for the coupler. Standard trailer balls are 1 7/8", 2-inch, and 2 5/16". So just match the coupler to the tow vehicle ball. All trailers need to have safety chains on them. These safety chains are very, very important. As you know, as you notice on this particular one, we've got the safety chains crossed in an X pattern. In case the coupler was to come loose from the tow vehicle, the safety chains would keep the trailer coupler from reaching the roadway. But always do that, and always attach the safety chains in an X pattern. Trailers are required to have lights. Make sure the lights work before you attempt to pull the trailer with a tow vehicle. Always a good idea to make sure that the trailer coupler fits tight, and always a good idea to put a lock on the coupler. This keeps somebody from your trailer becoming somebody else's trailer. Another great idea is to have a spare tire. Make sure you check the air pressure in this tire also. Doesn't do you a bit of good if it doesn't have any air in it. Spare tire, how many times have you been on the way to the lake and seen somebody on the side of the road looking at the boat trailer with a flat or a blown out tire that did not have a spare? Another piece of equipment you need on your boat is a tie down strap. This is in addition to the winch strap. Always make sure that when you get ready to launch the boat, that you take the tie-down strap off of the boat before you attempt to launch it. Another piece of equipment that you need to have installed before you launch the boat is a drain plug. Make sure the drain plug is installed before you launch your boat. Another piece of equipment that you need to make sure works on the boat is the engine cutoff switch. The engine cutoff switch is meant to be attached, one end attached to your PFD or to your belt. The other end is attached to the engine itself. And what the engine cutoff switch does is if you are thrown from the boat, it cuts the engine off. Here's a list of equipment that you need for your boat. The most important piece of equipment you'll need on any boat is a wearable personal flotation device. You'll need a wearable PFD for each person on board the vessel. If the vessel is 16 feet in length or longer, you'll also need a throwable device. You'll also need a sound producing device. And if you have fuel tanks that are permanently installed, you'll need a fire extinguisher. Always have your registration card on board. If you have any questions about boating safety, or if you want to take a boating safety course, call South Carolina Department of Natural Resources, 1-800-277-4301.